Hey YouTube, if you're new to this channel, my name is Chris. Thank you for joining and following along. If you've been here for a long time, thank you. I really appreciate it. And if you've ever considered becoming a member of this channel or wonder what that is, I'm going to show you a video about some work I'm about to do on this car that I uploaded here a few weeks ago for my members. And I'm going to bring you up to speed on the conversation we've had. Then we're going to get into the work that we're about to do. Hey members, I hope you're all doing good. It's Friday. I thought I'd throw out a quick video of a little project I got going on. Let me show you what I'm working on. So the whole time I've had this car, I've had this very strange oil consumption issue with this engine. Now, when I got this thing, you know, this thing had been cobbled together by somebody. They spent a lot of money, but things were not finished. Pretty much so nothing worked. And one of the problems I've had is the positive crankcase ventilation system was never finished on this car. So there was basically none. All there was a hose, this hose here from one valve cover over into the intake manifold, and that was it. The other valve cover back here, which is this line, was capped off, and the intake manifold, or below the intake manifold in the engine valley, that was capped off, and that was the whole, that was it. And that's really bad. You do not want to have everything capped off on the engine because the engine builds up pressure. Minute amounts of gas does sneak past the rings. It pressurizes the crankcase and you can blow out the front and rear crankshaft seals. And I have experienced some oil on the ground when I first got this car from the rear of the engine and, possibly about, you know, from that. So I had to work out the crankcase positive ventilation system and try and figure it out. And looking online, there's a bunch of different pictures for the LS setup. There's a bunch of different applications. I bought a canister kit, which is down below. Let me see if I can get a video of it. Here's a canister that this thing right there is the canister that I added. And basically, I also added the hose that comes off of the back of the valve cover. This hose here, it comes around through underneath the injectors, pops out here. It tees into the valley underneath the intake manifold. There's a plate down there that seals the top of the engine. It goes into that, and then it goes down to that canister, and then comes back up to here. I don't know if I can get that on video, and then goes into the bottom of the intake manifold. Okay, so that is a setup that I saw online for the LS engine, and I do get oil in that little canister. I unscrew it, throw that away because it's dirty oil, I guess. I don't know. But I'm still running into this issue where I'm burning oil, I'm using oil. The last time I put oil, I put 3 quarts of oil in this thing after driving a few hundred miles, which is like the car doesn't smoke. Okay, there's no smoking during startup. There's no, it doesn't smoke when I'm driving. There's none. So where the hell is this oil going? You know, I can't figure it out. If I pull this line out, there's no oil in here. There's nothing in there. But when I was hanging out with Dave's Mobile Works here the other day, he pulled the sensor out, which goes into the intake manifold, the MAP sensor, and there was oil on this. So what we're thinking is that there's oil going from this line, which comes from the canister, into the intake manifold. So there is oil going into the engine. How much, I don't know, but it's getting burned. There's a lot of soot on the tailpipes. Always has been. It's not greasy or oily. It's soot, but it's black. I always just thought because this thing run, you know, because it's got such a gnarly cam that it just isn't burning fuel, at idle, you know, it's really toxic when you're sitting here in the car. It's just when it's idling, you can smell unburnt fuel because there's just so much cam. My tuner, I talked to him when I had this thing on the treadmill, and he said that, you know, there's just not much you can do about that when you're at idle. So it's just going to, because it's just got so much cam that it's just not going to burn gases at idle. Makes sense. Okay. So what is my problem? We come to the conclusion that this thing is literally vacuuming the oil out of the engine, probably from that catch canister. So it's pulling this line at the bottom, or this line here at the intake manifold, is causing a vacuum, which is pulling oil through backwards through the system, through the valve covers, and out, and the lifter valley, which is this valley cover at the top of the engine. It's pulling oil into the intake manifold back here and burning it through the engine. That's what we're thinking. So why would it be doing that? And we come to the conclusion, because it's missing this. This system does not have what's a PCV valve. This is a one-way valve that is meant to prevent this from happening. So I went and picked this up. This is a pass-through line. There's a lot of different ones you can get for different cars. This is a 3/8 both ends, and this is a pass-through. This is going to fit on that hose, and I'm going to put it right here, or maybe even down below, a little bit further down below, kind of where it's easier to get to, and stop this thing from vacuuming out the oil pan, basically, and burning all that oil. That's the thought. That's the plan. So I'm going to test it, but it's definitely missing this part. It's nowhere in the system. Yeah, so it's like, what is happening, you know? And trying to figure out this thing, like I said, there's so many descriptions online. I've asked a bunch. I've seen a bunch of forums. I've just gone and looked and looked and looked, trying to figure this out. And this is what I've come to the conclusion. So I'll be installing this. Like I said, I'm going to do a video, something similar to what I'm doing now, but a little bit more in-depth with some graphs and pictures and testimony. You know, and then obviously installing this thing. So that'll be coming down the line. I know I said, hey, I'm done with the car and I'm going driving, but I need this. I need to get this oil consumption thing, or wherever the hell it's, you know, being teleported to, get that figured out. And I think this is the solution here. So we're just going to put this in and report back. So look for a full video on this and see, you know, what happens when we're done. Other than that, things running great. Anyways, I hope you guys have a great weekend, and we'll see you out there. So if you're interested in getting videos that just go to the members section, please consider putting a link in the description below, and you will see stuff earlier than everybody else, and you'll see just videos that I post maybe once, twice, more a week. Doesn't matter, you know, I just kind of, it's all on the fly. Really a lot less editing and more just doing. Anyway, I thought I'd throw that out, and let's get to the work. Let me show you what I'm going to do. The plan is just to put this in line on the hose that goes into the bottom of the intake manifold. So let's do that. I'm just going to see if I can either cut in the middle of the line. I'll pull that off and find a safe place for it, and we'll get that in place. I don't even know if that hose will come off. Let's find out. Okay, good. All right. Wonder if I can get this thing in there like that. Just put a couple clamps on it and put it back on there. Let's see if this works. It'd be a simple fix if it works, boy. That'd be nice. We have to do something else here. I got another idea. Reangle this thing here. Change the angle of the dangle. See if I can get this thing up through here with this thing. I have to go into the car. Okay. Just get this to come straight up between there.
Being a pain. Maybe this way. It's hard to see. I know you can't see nothing. Okay. I'll bring you in here in just a second. Show you exactly what I'm doing. See if we can put this on there. Go under the throttle body. And then we'll go straight onto there. So here we got it. Going into the bottom of the intake manifold right there, right behind the throttle body. And down to the catch can. Blocks it so it can't go in. I'll report back here in a couple weeks and after driving this thing and see if she stops this thing of ingesting oil. We're going to find out. Anyway, just a short video. Thought I'd show you and catch you in the next one. Peace.